When the days are cold and the cards all fold and the saints we see are all made of gold. When your dreams all fail and the wounds we hail are the worst of all and the bloods run stale. I wanna hide the truth, I wanna shelter you. There's nowhere we can hide. No matter what we breed, we still are made of greed. This is my kingdom come. This is my kingdom come.
Well, I think it's hard work and dedication. You know, a lot of people aspire to become soccer players because they watch, you know, other important soccer players have played the game before and have been successful on the field. So I think it's more about dedication, hard work on the field, and basically just playing the game with a lot of happiness and joy in your face. And, you know, because not a lot of people have the opportunity to go out there to become professional soccer players and make it well and do well in life. But so I feel as though it's about hard work, dedication, and also being a modest human being. You know, you just can't, little things that you take for granted are things that, you know, will basically throw you off guard sometimes. So, you know, if you have a little kid who comes to you and wants an autograph, and, you know, just be a modest human being, sign the autograph for him and, you know, and move on to the next kid. So I think hard work, dedication, and your modesty. Well, I faced a lot of obstacles. One of the obstacles I faced was the challenges that lie ahead of me. I had to go through a lot of tryouts, train with a lot of teams, you know, just to see if I could make it to a team or get signed, to say the least. You know, I know when I was in college, you know, my dreams were to play on a really, really good team and play with players who obviously know the game. Because I think my, you know, one of my things is, you know, to be the best, you have to play with the best. So I think one of the obstacles that I would face during the time was, you know, I go to train and try out with some teams and, you know, maybe they didn't need me or maybe they didn't like what they saw. And, you know, I mean, that comes with the territory. You know, you go around and you're trying out for teams and, you know, maybe you have a coach say, hey, look, go work on this and go work on that and maybe you come back next year. Those are the things that I was faced with when I started out, you know, and looking to try out and make it to the MLS and make it to become a professional soccer player. But I knew going into it, it was something that, you know, was going to happen, something that I knew that I was definitely going to have to go through to, you know, finally make it to where I needed to be. Well, I wanted to be a coach to the young ones because, you know, it's all about giving back. That's one of the points. The second thing is, you know, I want to make sure that I'm, you know, extending my talent level. You know, I extend my talents to the youth. If I want them to believe that if I could do it, you know, they could do it as well. I want them to also have that belief in themselves that, you know, it's not just about, you know, coming out and doing things on the field. I think you have to have the dedication. You have to be motivated. You know, you have to have the perseverance as well, you know, for all these things to happen for you to become successful. I want to really touch the hearts of little kids, you know, because when I see them run around, it reminds me of those days when I was younger and I was in their shoes as well. And I want to aspire to become, you know, one of the other better players that, you know, I looked up to when I was younger. So being able to give back to the community as well, because there's nothing like helping kids, you know, if it means training them for an hour, you know, teaching them how to strike the ball, teaching them how to dribble the ball, teaching them how to score a goal, and the little things like that, you know, goes a long way for a little kid. You know, they're aspiring to become better, a better soccer player. So I basically want to give back and, you know, make sure I'm helping kids to get to that level. I would just basically tell them to be themselves, okay? because I think one of the things that a lot of kids and young players are faced with when they go try out at a club or they're invited to come for a coach to take a look at them, I think they try to think the game. And then once you do that, I think you fall into situations where you don't excel, you don't do well because you're adding more pressure to yourself. So I think my advice for kids is be yourself, okay? Don't try to show that, you know, you could do this or you do that. Go on the field and just basically be yourself. You also have to be an honest human being when you go out there, okay? Because, you know, life is so short, you know, you never know what can happen. So when you go out there to go play or you're going out there to become a professional soccer player, you got to be honest with yourself and you also got to have the motivation. You have to encourage yourself to push yourself to get to the next level and not just settle for being the second best. Always want to be the best. You want to take advantage of every opportunity you have. So if you have a chance to get a tryout or you have a chance to, you know, go pro or, you know, play in a different country or play for teams, give it the best shot you could ever have. And that's the bottom line.
Being realistic is the most commonly traveled road to mediocrity. Greatness is not this wonderful, esoteric, elusive, godlike feature that only the special among us will ever taste. You know, it's something that truly exists in all of us. It's very simple. This is what I believe, and I'm willing to die for it. Period. We didn't grow up with the sense that where we were was where we were going to be. You know, we grew up with the sense that where we were almost didn't matter because
we were becoming
something greater. The separation of talent and skill is one of the greatest misunderstood concepts for people who are trying to excel, who have dreams and want to do things. Talent you have naturally. Skill is only developed by hours and hours and hours of beating on your craft. I've never really viewed myself as particularly talented. Where I excel is ridiculous, sickening work ethic. You know, while the other guy's sleeping, I'm working. While the other guy's eating, I'm working. There's no easy way around it. No matter how talented you are, your talent is going to fail you if you're not skilled. You know, if you don't study, if you don't work really hard and dedicate yourself to being better every single day, you'll never be able to communicate with people, with your artistry, the way that you want. So the only thing that I see that is distinctly different about me is I'm not afraid to die on a treadmill. You might have more talent than me, you might be smarter than me, but if we get on the treadmill together, right, there's two things. You're getting off first, or I'm gonna die. It's really that simple. You don't try to build a wall. You don't set out to build a wall. You don't say, I'm gonna build the biggest, baddest, greatest wall that's ever been built. You don't start there. You say, I'm gonna lay this brick as perfectly as a brick can be laid. Yeah. And you do that every single day.
Soon
you have a wall. I wanna represent an idea. I wanna represent possibilities. I wanna represent the idea that you really can make what you want. One of my favorite books is The Alchemist, Paulo Coelho. And I just believe that. I believe that I can create whatever I want to create. The first step before anybody else in the world believes it is you have to believe it. There's no reason to have a plan B because it distracts from plan A. Confucius said, he who says he can and he who says he can't are both usually right.
guess the last of all, when the lights fade.